Okay, hello everyone. So we are from group one. We'll be present about customer service. And group one consists the group member. For the first one is Anissa Putri Zafia, Azim Zati Esrizal, Riri Permatasari, and Yeli Triamanda. Next slide, please. Okay, this section will be present by Anissa Putri. To Anissa Putri, time is yours.
Okay, thank you, Azim. This is a definition customer service. Customer service is the set of activities and programs undertaken by retailers to make the shopping experience more rewarding. These activities increase the values customers receive from the merchandise and service they purchase. Some of the services are provided by store and call center employees interacting directly with customers, whilst others are provided by the design of the retailer stores and our website. This is strategic advantage towards customer service. Customer service provide a strategic advantage because good service can be important to customers, difficult for competitors to duplicate, keeps customer returning to retailers, and generates positive word of mouth combination, which attracts new customers. List some of the service provided by retailers. Most of the test service furnish information about the retailer's offerings and makes it easier for customer to locate and buy its product and service. Service such as donation and assembly or merchandise actually adapts the merchandise to fit the needs or specific customers. This point, customer service approach. The develop a sustainable customer service advantage retailers offer a combination of personalized and standardized service. And number two, standardized service is based on establishing a set of rules and producers for providing high quality service and ensuring that they get implemented constantly. The effectiveness of standardized service relies mainly on the quality of the retailer's policy and procedures and store, as well as its website design and layout. And then point use of service approach. As we discussed in chapter 4, the buying process that consumers go through depends on the consumer's past experience and thus arrives excited with the purchase decision. This the level of customer service and personalized information desired from sales associates varies for different buying situation. Most consumers have significant knowledge and experience shopping for most products sold by supermarkets, convenience stores, and general merchandise retailers. Okay, back to moderator.
Okay, thank you Anissa Putri Zafia. The next section will be present by Kak Yeli. To Kak Yeli, time is yours.
Thank you, moderator. I will explain about customer evaluation of service quality. Customers are satisfied when the purchase service met or exceed their expectation. There are dissatisfied when they feel the service fell below their expectation. So when retail attempt to differentiate their offering by developing a reputation for outstanding customer service, they need to consider both the perception of the actual service overhead and expectation of their customer. Next, please. Perceived service. Customer perception of the retail's customer service depend on the actually service delivered. However, because service or intangible is difficult for customer to evaluate the service offered by retail accurate. Five customer service characteristics that affects perception of service quality are the first one is the reliability. Reliability is the ability to perform the service dependently and accurately, such as performing and service for promise or contracted or meeting promise delivery. The two is assurance. Assurance is the knowledge and competency of employee and their ability to convey trust trust and confidence. Three is tangibility. Tangibility is associated with the approach of physical facility, equipment, personnel, and communication material. Four is empathy. Empathy refers to the caring individual attention provided to customer. Five is responsiveness. Responsiveness means to provide customer service, personnel, and sales associate that really want to help customer and provide from service. Next, please. The role of expectation. In addition to perception of the actual service delivered, expectation affect the judgment of service quality. Customer expectations are based on customer knowledge and experience. For example, when the basis past experience, customer have different expectations for the quality of service offered by different types of retails. Customer expect a traditional supermarket to provide convenient parking, be open from early morning to late evening, have an intuitive layer position and display product so they can be easily found and after a fast and pleasant checkout experience. Next, please. Next is knowing what customer want and the knowledge gap. The first step in the providing good service is knowing what customer want, need, and expect, and then using this information to improve customer service. Retail can reduce the knowledge gap and develop a better understanding of customer expectation by undertaking customer research, increase interaction between retail manager and customer, and provide communication between manager and the employee who provide customer service. The first one is social media. Retail can learn a lot about their customer expectation and perception of their service quality by monitoring what they say about the retail offering and offering of competitor and their social network, book, and YouTube. Two is survey panel and contents. Many retail survey customer immediately after the retail transaction has occurred. I'll talk some retail use survey. I just describe other interview panel of 10 to 25 customer to gain insight into expectation and perception. Three is interact with customer either directly and through observation. Owner manager of small retail first typical have daily contact with their customer and get accurate. Four is customer complaint. Customer complaint allow retail to interact with their customer and accurate detailed information about their service and merchandise. Five is feedback from the store employees. Five in using customer research, collecting information about customer expectation and perception is not enough. The knowledge gap diminishes only when retail use this information to improve service. That's all for me. Back to moderator.
Okay, thank you, Kak Eli. And the next section will be presented by me. So, okay. Customer complaints. Complaints allow retailers to interact with their customer and acquire detailed information about their service and merchandise. Customer complaints can provide useful information. Retailers cannot rely solely on the source of market information. Feedback from store employee and using customer research, collecting information about customer expectation and perception is not enough. acknowledged GAP diminishes only when retailers use this information to improve service. Feedback on service performance need to be provided to employee in a timely manner. And setting service standard, the standard of GAP. The next step is to use this information to set standard and develop system for delivering high quality services. Service standards should be based on customer perception rather than internal operation. To close the standard GAP, retailers need to, first one is commit their firms to providing highly quality service. And second one is define the role of service providers. And the third one is set service goals. And the last one is measure service performance. And what is commitment to service quality? Service excellence is achieved only when top management provide leadership and demonstrate commitment. Top management must be willing to accept the temporary difficulties and even the increasing costs associated with improving service quality. And the second one is about defining the role of service providers. Managers can tell service providers that they need to provide excellent service, but only clearly indicate what excellent service means. Without a clear definition of this retailer expectation, service providers are directionless. The third one is setting service goals. To deliver consistent, highly quality service, retailer need to establish goals or standard to guide employee. These goals should be based on their belief about the proper operation of the business rather than the customer and need expectation. Employees are motivated to achieve service goals when the goals are specific, measurable, and participatory in the sense that the employee participate in the setting them. Employee participate in the setting service standard lead to better understanding and greater acceptance of the goals. And the last one is measuring service performance. Retailers also use mystery shoppers to assess their service quality. This professional shopper visits stores to assess the service provided by store employee and the potential presentation of merchandise. And next slide, please. Okay, thank you. And this is meeting and exceeding service standards or the delivery GAP. To reduce the delivery GAP and provide service the exceed standard, retailer must give service provider the necessary information and training, empower employee to action in the customer and firm's best interest, provide instrumental and emotional support, provide appropriate incentiveness, improve internal communication, and use technology. And maybe that's all from me. And the next section will be presented by Riri Permatasari. To Riri, time is yours.
Okay, thank you, Azim. Okay, I would like to continue about presentation. This is, I would like to explain about communicating and the service promise, the communication GAP. This is the realistic commitments from, this is about promotion program or typical development by the marketing department. Where is the store operation division deliver the service. The next is managing customer. This is about expectation. How can a retail communicate a realistic service expectation without losing a business to competitor that makes inflated service claim? One common problem is not having clear expectation how long a customer has to wait at the delivery counter. Next slide, please. Okay, this is about service recovery. This the first one is listening to customer.
customer can become very emotional about their real or imaginary problems with a retail. Often this emotional reaction can be readjusted by simply giving customer a chance to get their complaint of their class of their case. The next one about providing a fair solution. Customer like feel that they are being treated fairly. They base their perception of fairness on how they think others were treated in similar situation and with other retailers. The third one is resolving problems quickly. This customer satisfaction is affected by the time it takes to get the issue resolved. So improving their first contact implied to move quickly to solve a problem increases customer satisfaction. The next, please. Okay, that's all for me. Back to moderator.
Okay, thank you very much, Riri, for the explanations. And we are from group one that already explained about the service and customer. And maybe that's all for us. And I'm sorry for the mistaken. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.